So you could probably tell from the title of this video, but I am back home. I came back home for my graduation and I'm so excited to see all my friends. I can't wait. It feels like I just moved to Toronto, but it's kind of nice to have a little break up from the city and get to come back home for a visit. I'm really excited for graduation tomorrow. I have the honor of doing the valedictorian address, so I am very excited for that. I've been practicing lots, so hopefully that goes well. It's kind of confusing because I always say home, but I guess I live in Toronto now, but where I'm from, it's just forever gonna feel like my home to me.
Naomi Rose Colford.
I would now like to call upon Naomi Colford, Bachelor of Science, Nursing, to deliver the valedictory address.
Thank you for the introduction, Belinda. Gui. Hello, everyone, and welcome. First off, I would like to thank everyone who made today possible and supported our graduates up to this point. Thank you to President Dingwall, the faculty, staff, and families. Most importantly, I would like to congratulate Cape Breton University's fall graduating class of 2022. We did it! I am honored and grateful to be standing here in front of you today to deliver Cape Breton University's valedictorian speech for this incredible graduating class. We are here to celebrate all of our hard work and our experiences. The wide variety of activities and opportunities at Cape Breton University has enabled us to forge our own unique path on our class's common journey towards graduating here today. Although each of us was on our own scholastic path, we gained so much more aside from our education during our time at Cape Breton University. From studying in the library, having lunch in the cafeteria with friends, the paint fight during Week of Welcome, and cheering on the fantastic sports teams. So many lifelong friendships and unforgettable memories were made. We may live during a time of instant gratification, with instant texting, messaging, and communication. But we have all been able to commit to the successful path of obtaining our degree. This success was a long-term commitment. As a class, we even had the challenge of a pandemic during that journey. Us making it to this point here today shows extreme perseverance. I'm sure we have all faced obstacles and setbacks during our degree. Obtaining a university degree is not a simple task. Truly passionate people can never be deterred from achieving their goals and dreams. This graduating class is proof of this. We did not let setbacks deter us. Remember, if one door closes, another door will open. Sometimes things work out better than you could have imagined. Rejection is merely a redirection, a course correction to your destiny. This is a quote I love by Bryant McGill. I landed the job of my dreams right out of my degree. I work in the top level newborn intensive care unit at the Hospital for Sick Children in Toronto, which is currently ranked the number one pediatric hospital in the world. I truly believe the phenomenal education I received at Cape Breton University helped me greatly to secure that position. I would like to thank my family and friends for always supporting me. I would also like to give a special thank you to my gram, who sadly passed last February. She was also a nurse, and she was ecstatic when I was accepted into nursing at Cape Breton University. I am so proud to be graduating today with my Bachelor of Science in Nursing and joining the CBU alumni. I would like to end with a quote by Confucius to the graduates. Wherever you go, go with all of your heart. Congratulations, everyone. We made it. Well, Alan, thank you.
So I am back home. I got back home a couple days ago, but it's just been such a quick trip that it's been an absolute blur, and I haven't vlogged anything. I had my graduation, and it was so nice to see everyone again. I miss my friends so much, and as a graduating class, my nursing class were super close, so it was lovely to see everyone again and to do my valedictorian address, which I put a video clip in of. I'm sure you've already seen it because I think that it's gonna go before this clip. Didn't get to vlog there, I was just so busy. And then I've been trying to meet up with different friends while I'm home, going to lunch and dinner with family. So it's been a really, really nice time. I feel like I'm not here long enough, but I'm just about to go out with my friend Haley. We're gonna do our usual routine. We have a spot that we love to go to for breakfast wraps, and then we're gonna go to Starbucks, and then probably a Lululemon and Winners trip. That's like an ideal day for me, an ideal afternoon. Also, my favorite part of my speech was when at the beginning I go, "We did it!" And after that, I thought that that was so unique and original, but two people came up to me and they were like, "Oh my gosh, your Elle Woods moment, I loved it." And I'm like, my Elle Woods moment? Like, I love Legally Blonde, don't get me wrong. I've watched it probably numerous times, but not as of recently, but apparently Elle Woods says we did it.
We did it! We did it!
It in her speech, and I went after and I watched it. And it is very similar. So, you know what? I had my Elle Woods moment, and I actually love that that ended up working out like that, but it was not planned at all. So if you watch it and you think that too, or probably not, maybe that was just a coincidence. I didn't know when I first originally, that wasn't planned. Book 'em now, baby, you're casting your spell on. So we got Christmas Starbucks drinks. What did you get?
Sugar cookie oat milk latte made with 2 pumps of sugar-free vanilla.
How is it?
I got the opposite. I got a venti because I was using stars, so got it.
I'm blocking the mess.
Oh my gosh, I was wondering, I thought you spilled something. I got a venti iced sugar cookie oat milk latte with light ice blonde espresso, 2 shots of sugar cookie and 4 shots of sugar-free vanilla. So we're gonna try. It is so good. And the sugar cookie is actually, I was scared that I wouldn't be able to taste it, but I can taste it quite well, even though there's only 2 shots in it. Did you rate it out of 10? I can't remember.
No. 9.5, which I got a venti and some cream coleslaw.
I will also give this a 9.5. I had it yesterday hot, and I think I like it hot slightly better. But usually I'm an ice girly.
Little betrayed. Probably because you put the straw.
That's a little rude. I don't see any sprinkles in mine. That's a little, it's a little rude. Like, I can't even see them at the bottom. Anyways.
I got mine.
I'm officially back in Toronto. It feels good to be back. I really miss my friends here while I was gone, and it's nice to get back to my job. I had such a nice visit home, and I love seeing everyone and getting to be back for a little visit. It was so nice. I hope you enjoyed this week's video. Please subscribe so you don't miss next week's video. Thank you so much for watching.